वेलकम बैक अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ परमुटेशन। यस्टरडे वी टॉक अबाउट थ्योरम 5.1 एंड थ्योरम 5.2। आई गेस दिस 5.1 एंड 5.2, दिस टू थ्योरम्स। 5.1 सेज दैट एवरी परमुटेशन ऑफ ए फाइनाइट सेट कैन बी रिटन एज ए साइकिल or a product of disjoint cycles, okay? And all we know that what we mean by product of cycles and what we mean by disjoint cycles, okay? So any permutation, if you are taking, then they can be certainly written as a product of disjoint cycles, okay? So what is the benefit of writing in terms of cycle or disjoint cycle? So about that we were discussing in the last lecture, okay? One thing is that if we are writing some permutation in terms of cycle, so it means that we are shortening, first thing that is, we are shortening the the way of representation, fine? And then another thing is that with the help of cycles, if they are disjoint, then we conclude that they should commute. For example, if you are writing 1, 2 and then 3, 4, then we can very much write 3, 4 and 1, 2, okay? So this is the thing, fine, okay? So disjoint cycle commute, fine. So these two things we had done yesterday, and today we are going to continue our discussion on some more properties of permutation. So let us see. For that we have theorem number 5.3. Order of a permutation, it is talking about order of permutation. This is one of another aspect or another importance of when we are writing some permutation in terms of cycles, okay? So this theorem says that if there is some permutation, for example, suppose alpha is a permutation and there are so many cycles, C1, C2, C3, for example, if we are writing suppose some alpha is per some permutation is there, so we are writing 1, 2, 4, 5 and then 7, 8, fine. So there of course I have written two cycles only. You can write more cycles like 9, 10 and then 11. There may be 3 cycle, 4 cycle, 5 cycles also, there is no problem. So alpha is some permutation, and in view of theorem 5.1, every permutation can be written as a product of cycles, disjoint cycles, okay? So if alpha is some permutation, and for example, I have written them in terms of product of disjoint cycles, okay? And then this theorem says that the order of this permutation, that is order of alpha, okay? Because alpha is a permutation, so this is going to be certainly member of some Sn, for some n. Alpha is going to be in some n for some fixed n, fine. And here in case, in this case, this n may be n equals to 11 because 11 symbols, maximum 11 symbols are appearing. So we may see or we may say that n equals to 11, but we are not sure really, okay, unless it is given. Anyway, so alpha is a permutation, we have written like this. So what will be the order of this, fine? So this theorem suggests that the order of alpha will be nothing but least common multiple of length of cycles, okay? So this length is 2, length is 2, and then less length is 2, and then length is 3. So we need to find LCM of 2, 2, 2, any times we can write, doesn't matter, or we are writing only one time, okay? So LCM of 2 and 3, what will be the LCM of 2 and 3, least common multiple?
6.
Hello. You know what is how you find the least common multiple. So you
Yes,
can
sir.
write multiple of 2. 2 is 2, 4, then 6, then 8, then you can write down 10, then 12, and count it down further. And then 3, and then 6, all right? Then 9, and then go on. So you need to find the multiple of 2 and 3, which are same, and this should be least. Of course, in future, we will be getting more. After this, we will be having 12 also. But this is not least. Least is what? 6. So this is going to be 6. So according to this theorem, the order of alpha will be 6. Fine? Order of alpha will be 6. Okay. So this is interesting, or this is one of the application we are going to get from this theorem. Okay, important result. Okay, so thing is that let us see how we can prove this one. But before proving this one, we need to know something that or I can write. Let us write here note. A cycle of length R has order R. A cycle of length R has order R. Okay. So if you are writing like this, 1, 2, what will be the order of this cycle? 2. You can try it, because 2 cycle is self inverse always. Fine. If you are writing some 1, 2, and 3, and then order of this one is going to be 3. If I am writing cycle 1, 4, 5, 7, 9, what will be the order of this one according to this the note we have written here? 5. Fine, because length is 5. Okay, so this you can verify. The proof is very simple, not so tough, but at least you can try it out, or I can give you hint. So for this, you can take hint this one. I am just proving this one, giving hint to this one, and after that I will be starting. I will be talking about the proof of theorem 5.3. Okay. So a cycle of length R has order R. Thing is that. Okay. So let alpha equals to alpha be some permutation, and let it be some cycle. Okay. Let it be A1, A2, and up to AR. It has length R. Of course, all AI are distinct. Fine. That's why this is a cycle. Okay. All right. Then, of course, if you are trying to get the image of A alpha A1, this is going to be A2. Fine. Alpha 2 A1. This is going to be alpha of A1. And this is alpha of A2. And A2 mapped onto, after that, there will be A3. Fine. Similarly, alpha 3 A1, this is going to be A4. Okay. You can continue alpha R minus 1 A1. This is going to be mapped on which element? Hello? Anyone?
A1 pe jayega.
A1 pe kaise jayega? AR. R minus 1. I am writing R minus 1.
Yes, sir. Ye AR pe jayega.
A alpha, alpha R A1. This is equals to AR plus 1. But AR plus 1, there is no element like this. But if we can take this, reduce this this index under modulo addition modulo R. Okay, so this is going to be the thing, but A1, fine? Because cycle terminates here at AR, fine? So image of AR will be A1, of course. So what we are getting, what we observe here, we see that alpha R A1 equals to A1 and R is least. R is least. Similarly, you can check alpha R and any element AI equals to AI को ये map करेगा कहाँ पे map करेगा AI पे map करेगा ठीक है ना you can verify similar in the similar way or you can write similarly we can prove this one okay fine so हर element self map हो रहा है किसके alpha R ठीक है ना and R time जब उसको क्या कर रहे composition R time ले रहे हो fine so thus alpha to the power R is nothing but identity. Are you getting this one? And R is least. So this implies that order of alpha equals to R. Fine. Are you getting this one? Hello. Yes, hello.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. अच्छा one thing you tell me alpha अगर हम j alpha j और इसको AI इस पे operate कराते हैं this is AI so ये किस पे map होगा A J plus I पे पक्का कोई दिक्कत नहीं
सर visible नहीं है सर आप जो लिख रहे हैं
दिखा नहीं आप लोगों को
बहुत देर बाद आता
है हेलो यस
सर आप लिख के भर जाते हैं उसके बाद आता है सर मतलब लैग कर रहा है सर
ओके ओके अभी दिखा
यस सर दिख गया
यस सर
ओके
सर जे प्लस आई मॉडलो आर होगा
हाँ 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 दैट यू कैन रिड्यूस If I plus J or J plus I is less than or greater than R, then you can reduce to modulo R. ठीक है? Index को. Fine. So clear है. Now we can. I guess we can now look for the proof. Fine. चलें start करें proof. ठीक है. So let us see the proof of theorem. So proof. Theorem 5.3, I guess it was 5.3. Fine. So let alpha equals to C1, C2. This is capital C1, C2. They are cycles. Okay. C1, C2 up to CS. Where CI are disjoint cycles. Fine. So theorem says that if some permutation alpha or some permutation is written as a product of disjoint cycles, then the order of alpha is equals to LCM of order of CI. Fine. Okay. यही हमें प्रूफ करना है. So let us see how we can prove. So for that, let us assume the order of CI. So let order of CI. ये सी आई क्या है सी आई आर साइकल्स ठीक है ना जैसे for example c1 ho gaya, agar maan lijiye aapne isse likhe a b c something like this, they are cycles, okay, wo elements waise nahi hai balki ye cycle hai. c2 aapne likh diya d e f g something like this, okay, I think things are clear to you, fine. मैं इसको सर्कल में कर दे रहा हूँ सो दैट यू नो दैट दिस इज रफ और समथिंग, फाइन. लेट अस सी. सो लेट ऑर्डर ऑफ सी आई इक्वल्स टू डी आई. सो आई रन्स फ्रॉम 1 अप टू एस, फाइन. ओके सो लेट अस, आई थिंक
विजिबल नहीं है,
स्क्रीन इज नॉट विजिबल.
आप जो लिखते हैं तो काफी देर बाद आता है वो विजिबल. ओके
ओके सो व्हाट आई कैन डू, ओके यू कैन जस्ट होल्ड ऑन, लेट मी सी द कनेक्शन.
स्क्रीन फिर से शेयर कर दीजिए आप.
लेट मी सी हेलो.
यस सर.
अभी दिख रहा है स्क्रीन?
हाँ सर दिख रहा है.
थैंक यू. सो आई वाज, वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रूफ ऑफ दिस थ्योरम. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट ऑर्डर ऑफ सी आई इक्वल्स टू डी आई. आई इक्वल्स टू 1 2 3 अप टू एस, fine. Then we need to prove that order of alpha is equals to least common multiple of di's. Okay, so let m equals to least common multiple of d1 d2 and ds, fine. Then if m is the least common multiple, fine, so m should be equals to k1 times d1 and this is equals to k2 times d2 and so on, ks times ds for some ki belongs to integer, fine. Are you okay with this? Because m is least common multiple, fine. So m is multiple of d1 d2 d3, okay, just like we have seen do hum logo ne example dekha 2 aur 3 ka, to iska 2 tha, 2 4 6, so they are multiple of 2, fine, and then 8, and then here 3 6 9, okay, so 6 is also multiple of 3, 2 is multiple of 2, fine, so like this, okay. So m will be equals to k1 d1 k2 d2 like this, okay, so So alpha to the power m, alpha is some permutation which was written in terms of disjoint cycles c1 c2 up to cs. Okay, so alpha to the power m equals to c1 c2 and so on, then cs. Fine, and then we can write c1 m, c2 m and cs m, and then let us replace c1 m with this one. So we have a k1 d1 and then c2 to the power k2 d2, and we can do it very much because m equals to k1 d1 k2 d2. All right, so here k2, okay, and then here ks ds. Fine, so this we can write this cd to the power k1, and then here c1, not c1 but c2 to the power d2, and then k2, then cs ks, and here
k1 hoga sir.
Yes, thank you. So you know, because d1 is the order of c1, d2 is order of c2, d3 is order of c3, like this. So what we have identity here, the identity here, and so on, and identity here. So all together it is going to give us an identity. Fine, all right, I think.
Yes,
so what we have, so this would imply that alpha to the power m equals to identity. Fine, all right. Does it mean that m is the order of alpha?
No sir, m least hona chahiye.
Yes, very good. You can note one point for this. But thing is that one thing we can very much conclude from here. What we can conclude, that order of alpha should divide m. Okay? Is it okay? Order of alpha should divide m.
Yes sir.
Fine. For example, if you have some element a to the power, suppose order of a is 3, then a cube equals to identity. Okay, then a to the power 6, you can write a to the power 3 times square. This is equals to a. So this 6 is always divisible by 3. Fine. So this I think we had proved this one. Okay, fine. But this much we can conclude, that alpha, order of alpha should divide m. Okay, that is n should divide m, where n equals to order of alpha. Fine. So this is, suppose let us star. Okay, so we have next, what we need to prove, we will prove that m also divides n. Fine. Next we will prove that m also divides n. It means with the help of these two, we can very much write that m equals to n. So this is our target, in fact. Okay, so for this, let order of alpha equals to n, then alpha to the power n equals to identity. Fine, and then alpha to the power n equals to c1 c2 up to cs to the power n. All right, and this is equals to identity, as we know. And one thing is very sure, that because c1 c2 and cs are disjoint cycles, so in their power also there will be no common element. They are disjoint. Fine, they are disjoint. This means that c1 to the power n equals to c2 to the power n, and so on, cs to the power n, they are going to be identity. This is because ci are disjoint. And so their powers. समझ रहे हो ना? अगर कोई disjoint cycle है तो उसमें कितनी भी power आप raise करो, ठीक है ना, वो भी disjoint होने वाले हैं. ठीक है, you can verify it. It's easy. Okay, fine. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ बेटा? See, अब we know that order of C1, C2 and CS. We all know. Fine. It means what?
Sir, n उसको divide करेगा.
It means D. That is order of C1, C2. D1 divides n. D2 divides n. Fine. And DS divides n. Fine. That is DI divides n for all I. Okay. So we are very close. And therefore, this would imply that the least common multiple of DI will also divide n. This implies that LCM of DI should also divide n. And this implies that M should divide n. Fine. So this is a star S. So from star and star S, we must have M divides N and N divides M. Both together will force us to write M equals to N. Okay. So what we have assumed? We assumed that order of alpha is N. So N is equal to M. So this implies that order of alpha equals to M. Fine. That is order of alpha equals to the least common multiple of order of CIs. Fine. Okay. So this is one of the important result. How beautifully we can find the order of an element. Okay. So जब भी कोई group मिले उसका आप इसी तरीके से operation की कितने order के कितने element है, ठीक है, और cyclic है कि नहीं, abelian है या नहीं है. So these all things we can see. That these make things interesting. Okay, there is some example I have kept. I kept some examples here. So you see, there are two cycle, the order of two cycles, product of two cycles. Fine. One thing is sure, that if I say that you tell me 1, 3, 2. So order of this is, this will be equals to what? This is three cycle, na?
Three.
All right. And then order of 4, 5. This is two cycle. Two. Will be two. Fine. So this is equals to LCM, least
LCM
common multiple of
two and three.
Fine. So here also, this is equals to least common multiple of. But thing is that you
four
need to
two.
Check. One word of caution is that you need to check that both cycles should be disjoint. Fine. If they are not disjoint, you have to write first them as disjoint cycle, and it is always possible. You can write. Fine. You first find the product and then break them as disjoint cycles. There is no problem. So here LCM of 4 and 2. This is going to be 4. And here one cycle is three cycle, and two cycles are three cycles, and one is two cycle. So LCM of 3 and 2.
Fine.
You can see here. This one is, this is the interesting one. This was what discussing. Okay. So you see, they are not disjoint cycles. We have 1, 2, 3, and then we have 1, 4, 5. Fine. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 4, 5 we have. Okay. So first we need to write them as disjoint cycle. So we have one cycle of length 5. Fine. So this is a product of single cycle of length 5. So the order of this is going to be 5. Fine. What if I write, for example, if I am writing 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. Okay. So can you tell me, suppose this is alpha, order of alpha?
15.
Okay, LCM of, you need to first see whether they are disjoint or not. So
3, 3, 5.
Order of 3 and then 3 and then we have 5. So here 15. So if they are not disjoint, then you need to write them as disjoint cycle, and then you can find it out what will be the order of that particular permutation. Okay. So for example, if you write suppose beta equals to 1, 3, 2 and 1. 2, 3, fine. So they are certainly not disjoint cycles. Fine. They are not disjoint cycle. So first you need to write them as disjoint cycle. So you need to write, you need to find the product of this. Fine. So here you start from right. 1 goes to 2. Fine. 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3. So 1 goes to 3. Fine. You can quickly find it out. 1 goes to 2. 2 goes to 1. 2 goes to 1, I guess, here. 2 goes to 1. 2 goes to 1, not 2 goes to 3. 1 is fixed. 1 goes to 2, and here 2 goes to 1. So 1 goes to 1. So we have one cycle here. Fine? Only single. So let us see about 2. 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 2. So 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 2. Then we have another single cycle. Fine. Hello. Are you getting?
Yes.
Yes, sir. 3, 1 pe jayega, sir. And then ek hi bacha hua hai, to 3 pe hi na? So, tino ko remove kar sakte. This is nothing but identity. Order of identity is 1. Fine. So, somehow so let us see some more example, like 1, 2, 3, and then 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can find it out what will be the product. Suppose this is a gamma. Okay, so 2 goes to here, 1 is not there in the right hand side. So 1 will be fixed under this cycle. So 1 goes to 1 and 1 goes to 2 here. Fine. So 1 goes to 2. 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. Okay. Or we can write like this. You can, if you are not getting this one. So you can see 1 goes to 1 here, 1 goes to 1, and 1 goes to 2, like this. Okay. Then you take a 2, 2 goes to 3, you are taking 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. Fine. And then let us take 3. 3 goes to 4, and 4 is fixed here in the left. Fine. The 4 is 4. And we are left with 4. 4 goes to 2. 4 goes to 2. And 2 goes to 3. Okay. So we can write it at this end cycle. So we are starting here. 1 and closing at 1. So 1, 2, there is one cycle. Fine. And then we have another cycle, 3, 2. So we have product of these two cycles, 1, 2, and 3, 4.
2, okay. Sir, alpha.
1, 2, 3, 4. And then order of gamma is equals to 2, certainly. Fine. So similarly, you can, if you are, you have been given some permutation, and they are not written in terms of disjoint cycles or cycles, cycles in their representation are not disjoint, you can write first them as disjoint cycle and then you get conflict. Fine.
सर ये disjoint में लिखना एक बार और बता दीजिए.
You just to find out the product of these two. Okay. So you got this one. Fine. So you take one. You can take any element. There is no problem. So here you have started with one. One goes to two. Two goes to one. So from where you have started, you are landing at some point of time on that element. So it means that one cycle is complete. So one, two, two, one. So we have one cycle here. Fine. And so this done and this done. So we are left with two more rows. So let us you can take four or three, whatever you feel like. Let us take three. Three goes to four. Four goes to three. So three goes to four. So this will constitute a two cycle again. So we are keeping three goes to four and four goes to three. Fine. In two cycle, if I write, I am writing one two. It means what? One goes to two and two goes to one, like this. We have two, one and two here. One goes to two and then two goes to one. Okay. Hello.
Sir, hello. Sir, ये one two three and two three four से ये कैसे change हो रहा है? ये नहीं समझ में आ रहा है.
आप जहां से स्टार्ट कर रहे हो ना, एक कोई एलिमेंट उठा लो, ठीक है ना. वन का इमेज कितना है? दो है. दो की इमेज कितनी है?
दो का
है, ठीक है ना. तो जहां से स्टार्ट किया था वो आ गया. तो जैसे ही आ गया तो आप उसका एक साइकिल बना दीजिए, वन टू, ठीक, पक्का. अब बचा रहा है ये दो कॉलम और बच रहे हैं. आप थ्री और चार में से दोनों में से कोई से उठाइए. आपको उठाना है ये डोमेन है और ये को डोमेन है, दैट इज इमेज है. फाइन. तो थ्री किस पे मैप हो रहा है? फोर पे मैप हो रहा है. फोर किस पे मैप हो रहा है? थ्री पे मैप हो रहा है. तो थ्री से उठाया, स्टार्ट किया था और फिर हम थ्री पे आ गए, तो एक साइकिल भी बन जाएगा, ठीक है.
यस सर.
नहीं आ रहा है? और देखें एग्जांपल, जिसे अब लिखते हैं वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन तक कर देता हूँ, ठीक है ना. अब इसमें मैं करता हूँ रेंडमली कोई भी नंबर, यहाँ पे कर दिया मैंने टू, यहाँ पे फाइव, यहाँ पे सिक्स, यहाँ पे फाइव कर दिया, यहाँ पे फोर कर दिया, यहाँ पे सिक्स तो है, यहाँ पे हमने सेवन कर दिया, ठीक है ना, यहाँ पे नाइन कर दिया, यहाँ पे एट कर दिया, यहाँ पे वन कर दिया, ठीक है. अब इसमें साइकिल बनाए ना, ठीक है. सपोज दिस इज डेल्टा, सो लेट अस राइट देम एज डिफरेंट साइकिल्स. फाइन. आप यू कैन पिक वन. आप यहीं से कोई भी एलिमेंट डोमेन का उठाइए. आप कौन सा लेंगे? वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव, व्हाट यू वेरी फील लाइक, यू आर फ्री, ठीक है ना. कहीं से भी करो, सबको मैप कराना. कौन सा लें?
वन
ले, वन लीजिए, टू लीजिए, व्हाट यू वेरी फील लाइक, ठीक है ना. वन लिया, वन किस पे मैप हो रहा है?
टू पे.
वन टू पे मैप हो रहा है, ठीक. टू किस पे जा रहा है?
फाइव पे
जा रहा है. टू फाइव पे जा रहा है. फाइव किस पे जा रहा है? ये भी हो गया, ये भी हो गया, ये भी हो गया. फाइव किस पे जा रहा है? फाइव फोर पे जा रहा है, ठीक ना. फोर को ढूंढो, फोर किस पे जा रहा है? फाइव पे जा रहा है, ठीक ना. देखिए यहाँ पे फाइव आई थिंक दो जगह तो नहीं लिख दिया, ये गलती की है. दो जगह आ रहा है ना यहाँ पे, फाइव नहीं आना चाहिए यहाँ पे. कौन सा मिस हो रहा
है?
आई थिंक थ्री मिस हो रहा है ना,
थ्री मिस हो रहा है.
हाँ, थ्री मिस हो रहा है. सो यहाँ पे हम थ्री लिखते हैं, ठीक है. यहाँ पे हम थ्री, ठीक है, चलिए. सो फाइव फोर पे गया, फिर हम देखते हैं फोर कहाँ पे जा रहा है. फोर थ्री पे जा रहा है, ठीक है ना. फोर ये थ्री हो गया, ठीक है. थ्री को डूडो कहाँ मिलेगा?
सिक्स पे.
थ्री सिक्स पे गया, थ्री सिक्स पे चला गया, ठीक है. अच्छा, ये भी हो गया. सिक्स को डूडो, सिक्स सेवन पे गया, सिक्स सेवन पे गया, और सेवन नाइन पे गया, सेवन नाइन पे गया, ठीक है ना. सेवन नाइन पे गया और नाइन वन पे गया, नाइन वन पे साइकिल पूरी हो गई, ठीक है ना. वन से स्टार्ट किया था, वन पे जब आ गए यहीं पे बंद हो गया एक, ठीक है. अब बच रहा है एट. अब ऐसे और भी हो सकते हैं. अब आपको चाहिए था ना, अगर मान लीजिए टेन था, यहाँ पे मैं टेन लिख देता तो दो बच जाते, एट एट और टेन टेन बच जाते, तो उनकी एक साइकिल बन गई, एट और यहाँ पे टेन टेन, ठीक है ना. क्योंकि 10 की इमेज 10 है, 8 की इमेज 8 है. तो अब बेटा इसको हम कैसे लिखेंगे, देखिए यहाँ से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, वन से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, टू फिर फाइव फिर फाइव फोर पे जा रहा है, ऐसे करके जा रहा है। तो साइकिल एक दूसरे की इमेज होते जा रहे हैं, ठीक है ना, इमेज की इमेज हम फाइंड कर रहे हैं। तो इसको लिखेंगे वन गोज टू टू, टू गोज टू फाइव, फाइव किस पे जा रहा है, अब नीचे वाला ये
सेवन नाइन
किस पे जाएगा, टू फाइव हो गया, फोर हो गया, थ्री हो गया, सिक्स हो गया, सेवन नाइन, ठीक है, और ये हो गया एट और ये हो गया टेन। अब एट टेन को आप रिमूव कर सकते हैं, यू कैन स्किप देम, सो वी आर लेफ्ट विद वन टू फाइव फोर थ्री सिक्स सेवन नाइन। ओके, अगर आप इसको रखते भी तो भी कोई बात नहीं। अब डेल्टा का बताइए आप ऑर्डर क्या होगा,
सेवन
सेवन होगा ना एलसीएम, ठीक है, आप समझ में आ गया आपको,
यस सर,
ठीक
है। अच्छा, अब ये इसको किसी भी ऑर्डर में लिखिए, ये यूनिक नहीं है रिप्रेजेंटेशन, इसको आप ऐसे भी लिख सकते हो, मैंने वन से स्टार्ट किया ना, आप कहते थे सर मैं तीन से स्टार्ट करूंगा, तो तीन से आता है नंबर, ठीक है ना, और तीन से अगर लिखना शुरू करो तो इसी ऑर्डर में लिखना, आप कैसे लिखोगे, इसी को अगर मान लो थ्री से स्टार्ट कर देते तो थ्री सिक्स सेवन नाइन, थ्री सिक्स सेवन नाइन, नाइन के बाद क्या आ रहा है, फिर यहाँ पे चले आओ इसके पास, वन के पास चले आओ, फिर इधर वन टू फाइव एंड फोर, फाइन, ये भी दोनों इक्विवेलेंट है, समझ रहे हो, क्या फर्क पड़ता है, ठीक है ना, यहाँ पे आपका वन हो गया, यहाँ पे टू हो गया, थ्री हो गया, फोर हो गया, फाइव, कहीं से स्टार्ट करो आप, ठीक है ना, साइकिल वही रहेगा, डायरेक्शन वही रहेगा, आपको डायरेक्शन ध्यान रखनी है, आप जिस डायरेक्शन में मूव कर रहे हो उसी डायरेक्शन में आपको मूव करना है, फाइन, चले आगे।
Yes.
So we have another theorem. This says that every permutation in Sn is a product of two cycles. ठीक है? Every permutation in Sn is a product of two cycles. And two cycle को हमने कुछ नाम दिया था. What was the name? You know? Do you remember? There was some particular name, transposition.
Yes, sir.
Two cycle is called transposition. Okay. So to prove this theorem, we know that you know one theorem that maybe this it was 5.1 I guess 5.1. It says that if alpha is some permutation, then it can be written as product of disjoint cycles. That all we know, fine, can be written as product of disjoint cycles. Okay, ab ye keh rahe hain ki har permutation two cycle ke form mein likha ja sakta hai, iska matlab ye hai ab yahan pe c1 c2 cs they may be of any length, samajh rahe ho aap, they may be of any length. To ab ye keh rahe hain ki ye jo any length kisi bhi length ka ye cycle hai na, isko aap ब्रेक कर सकते हैं टू साइकिल्स में हमेशा, समझ रहे हो, जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर राइटिंग वन टू थ्री, तो इसको हम लिख सकते हैं वन थ्री एंड वन टू, फाइन, अब प्रोडक्ट फाइन करके देख लेना ये भी आएगा, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव, इसको आप लिख पाओगे वन फाइव वन फोर वन थ्री वन टू, आप एक काम, ये जैसे पहला वाला जो है ना यहाँ पे, ये पहला वाला इसको फिक्स कर लीजिए, जितने भी आगे टू साइकिल लिखेंगे इट विल बी फिक्स्ड एट फर्स्ट प्लेस, और फिर रिवर्स ऑर्डर में लिखना शुरू कर दीजिए, पहले फाइव रखिए, फाइव रखा है ना, फिर फोर रखिए, फोर रखा है, एंड देन इन नेक्स्ट टू साइकिल थ्री रखिए, थ्री रखा है, एंड देन टू, आर यू गेटिंग, यू कैन वेरीफाई इट, ओके, बट थिंग इज दैट this is the way we can write, fine, okay. So what we are supposed to, we are only we need to suppose, we need to prove that every cycle can be written as product of two cycle, okay, aur har cycle jab likha jayega two cycle ke form mein to har permutation bhi likha jayega, kyunki permutation cycle ka product hota hai, theek hai na, koi dikkat nahi, okay,
no,
ठीक है।